Hey guys, Doug here. Dougie got a new axe. So, got a Grandfer's Scandinavian axe. I picked it up at the outdoor show on the weekend. And it's a great little axe. Had one before, to be honest, but I missed it. And they had a brand new shipment of Grandfer's axes. And if you know how hard they are, when you see them, you just buy them. So, hard to find, but I got one. So, I painted the handle red. Gave myself a little hanging hook loop, and don't like to whip the longer axes because I like to slide my hand on them, so that's why I don't do that. But anyway, I made a handle of mine, paint, lanyard. Now we got a sheath. So this Grandfer sheath is it's not a bad sheath. It's not a great sheath. It's very, very thin, and what I find over time is as these get wet, being so thin, this tends to stretch and then it gets loose and then it becomes sloppy. And bottom line is, I didn't make it, so it's not mine. So I want to make a new sheath head for this, so I thought I'd bring you along with me, and we'll bang together a real simple one. Just covers the blade and the snap goes up this way like that. So let's do that. Fair warning, if you are a leather worker or you know what you're doing with leather, you might want to give it a pass because you'll probably just get mad at me because I am not a leather worker. I just bumble my way through, but it's not something to be scared of. Anyone can do it, I guarantee you. So watch the video through if you are interested, and give her a go. Pretty simple. Let's go. All right, guys. Step number one. Need a piece of paper. Fold her in half. All right. Fold it in half. We're going to put that center crease. So if our sheath head is only going to come out about that far, so we're going to line that center. You can see that. The crease is centered with the steel on the top of the axe and to the point here. Okay? So then I'm just going to take that like that. I'm just going to carefully lay it down. Your thumb on here and open her up, and you can see the how I got that. So now we'll just basically, it's probably a good 3/16 on top down to not much, so it is a little bit of an angle, but it's okay. So we'll just trace our axe head. All right, that's it. Axe head is traced. So now we're going to add a good healthy half inch onto the face of that, like so. And that's for the welt. And then the same way, we're going to come back under the bottom a little bit, and then we'll just bring it up a little bit, like so. All right. And that's that. So now we'll fold her over the other way on the line. Take our scissors, cut her out. So, bam. Okay, that's your, so can you picture this now? That's it. Just like that. So we're missing one thing though. We're going to make gonna cut one more strip, roughly 1 inch, give or take a bit. All right, so that 1 inch is going to be your strap, but since we're dealing with leather, we're going to cut it all together. So we'll just lay it on here with a good angle so that it'll come back and put a piece of tape on it. Alright, so now we've got our sheath, like so, and our strap going to come up, and then if, say, the snap is going to be here, we'll just cut it off, like so. That is your template. That's it. So, now you need a piece of leather. I use So if this is about 3 ounce leather, I'm probably using, this is between 7 and 9 ounce, so more than twice as big. This has quite a little grain in it, but being a sheath, it doesn't bother me at all. In fact, I kind of like the extra little texture to it. So I'm going to take this. Now you got to remember, this is the inside of the sheath, right? So that's going to be the rough side. So the smooth side is going to be this side. So we have to make sure we put it down in the right way, which is going to be seem weird, but this will be upside down in a sense. All right. So finish side. And then we'll just trace her on here. All right. So now we've got it all drawn on here. So just take a nice sharp, put a new blade in, nice sharp knife, or if you got some good shears, and then just cut that leather out. And the most important thing is that you keep your blade straight up and down. No angle cutting and whatnot. So, all right, we'll cut this out and come back. Okay, so there's our piece all cut out. So now what we're gonna do is just talk about the game plan. We're gonna put a welt in to about here. That's the half inch piece of the third layer, the sandwich layer. It's gonna come down a half an inch and then just over another half an inch. And then we'll put two rivets here and then stitching down here. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna take this tool here. Looks like this, and I'm just going to put the stitching grooves in. So say if my one rivet's going to be here and here, I'm going to have stitching down here but nothing here. Okay, so I'm just going to go from about this point on both sides. So again, this isn't critical because we're going to run the stitches under and then we're going to put the rivets in last so that the heads might even cover some of the stitching. That's okay. So this is not a necessary tool. You could always use something like this to mark your stitching line. Just, you know, for a nice straight line, and even if you go over it a couple times, you'll still make a little groove. So you can always do that, but this actually cuts it right out. And again, if this is just so that the stitching sits down in the groove, so it's not necessary. Excuse me, just makes for a nice neat line. So, and this is all we're doing. On both sides, just so that it's done before we bevel the edges. All right. Okay, so that's it. Two little grooves in here. Okay, so like I said, we'll probably end up with a rivet, and rivet. So that's the only stitching on the sheath. Okay, let's move on to the welt. Nope, let's backtrack. Let's take the edges off. So what this tool here is just an edge beveler. And it's easier to do now before it's all put together. So all this does is just kind of takes a little angle off the leather. All right, just gives a nice smoother edge. If you're handy with a knife, you can do it with a knife. Like that. See how that goes? Just take that off with a knife. Again, not even necessary. So you don't have to do it. I just like to do it. So many of these, honestly, none of this stuff is done. This is just cut. So it's not that important, but it makes for a nice edge. So we'll do it on this. So I'll run this tool around all the edges and then we'll get into the welt. Alright, so we got that all nice and cleaned up a bit. So now we're going to work on the welt, and that's a half inch inner sandwich piece that protects so you can't cut the stitching or hit the rivets. So on your piece that you cut off, doesn't matter, but you could either you fold this back together, put it down, and you know, trace that angle and then make it a half an inch, or this piece that you cut off, if you can find roughly where you were, just do the same thing. Just run your finger on there and give her a good half inch all the way around your scrap. Okay, so let's cut that. Alright, now we're going to make it long. So there is our first piece of welt. Now, if you can see how that bunches up there, what you can do is take the edges off of here to make it not necessarily round, but just a little angle off both sides, and then you'll have a real nice tight fit when you put it together like that. Okay, so mark it to fit on your on there, so when you've got it where you want it for length, and just looks good, cut her out. Now you can trim it off more after anyway. So then we need just a little piece of half inch to go in the bottom. So let's make that. Alright, so that's there. This is going to come in like that. And we don't want, really all this bottom piece is going to do is to rest the point here on. You don't need it too far, otherwise you'll never be able to make that hook to get it in. So it's just long enough to get in there. And then even then, we'll take a little piece off the corner just so that we can have that little slide in. Alright. Cut. So basically, that's all we're doing. See that? Alright, let's get out the glue. Alright, so this is a contact cement I'm using. You can buy the contact cement in a nice little can that has the brush stuck right in the lid, which I normally have, but can't find one. But I'm just going to use a little brush here, a little cotton ball, and just dab it and run it on. But you can paint it on. You could actually crazy glue this together, because you're going to stitch it and rivet it anyway, remember? So, but for now, I'm just going to do this, so I'm just going to paint this on. Contact cement is obviously a contact cement, so it's not a cement that you're going to put together wet. So basically, you coat all the areas that you need, and you wait till it's beyond tacky, like just about dry, before you put it together. Now, when you put it together, you better have it exactly where you want it, because once it's stuck, it's stuck. So I'll just coat this, and then I'll have to probably take about 10 minutes for it to get dry enough to stick together, so I'll return. Okay guys, it's time to glue on our pieces here, so let's just get roughly, like I said, when it touches, that's where it goes, so try and keep your edges as close as you can to keep it flush with the outer edge, because that'll save some trimming up later. But if you don't panic, because we can trim the whole face off after. So there's the bottom, here's our little piece that we're gonna put on here, and we can trim this all up after, so like that. Alright,
And then we'll just roll this down and just hope that we're going to line it up perfectly. We'll go right to the bottom. Make sure that's even. And then just glue your way up. You can hear how tacky that is when it touches. Alright. Here we're pounding. That's glued. So now you got it all glued up. We'll just take your knife. If you did a rough job, that's not too bad, but a little bit rough. So you can just take your knife and then just clean her up so all three edges are all uniform here. Okay. Okay, so we got the edges cleaned up. Looks all right. I think I'm going to knock that little corner out the bottom just so we don't have a sharp point. Let's do that quick. All right. So there you go. There's our sheath so far. We'll do a test fit here. So remember, we're taking that point and we're just hooking it under. It's a little bit tight, but that's good. That's what we're going to have. Hard to see. But something like that. So, good. So far, so good. So right now, I'm going to drill the holes. And I lied. I said I was going to rivet this, but I just found out I don't have any rivets left. So we're going to put Chicago screws, which are basically these. Male and female screw post. And that's a male and a male. That's not right. Okay, so there we go, male and the female, and they just screw together. A little bit more expensive than a rivet for sure, but that's what I got, so that's what we're going to use. So I'm going to put one here, and one here. I'm just going to make the holes right now. I'm not going to put them in. So I have this little tool. You can, wherever you're, the female end, you just match up the hole. You can use a drill bit. Carefully use a drill bit and drill these holes if you don't have a punch. But that's roughly the same size, so I'm good already. So just put that in there and give her a good punch. Oh, that's turned. It's turned on me. I break these punches all the time too by just squeezing too hard. I don't know why, but I break everything. There we go. Okay. There's your hole. So I'll do two more and then we'll talk stitching. Alright, we got our three holes punched for our Chicago screws / rivets. So now we're going to talk the stitching. So I have the stitching groove there, you can see clearly. So I'm okay to run the stitching right up as close to the hole as needed, because these heads will end up covering some of the stitching if need be, which is fine. So we don't have to, it's not rocket science now. We'll just stitch as we feel, as close as we want to get to those posts. So I have a stitching wheel, which basically just runs in that groove. I can't see that. In that groove and marks the holes that way. But there's many different ways. You can take a fork, pretend it's a fork. You can take a fork and just kind of make little indents along, putting the last hole in the next hole and mark it that way for equal spacing. You can get these kinds of things, these little punches, and you can punch through and make your holes that way. But for me, I'm just going to mark it well with the stitching wheel, and I'm going to cheat. Real leather workers don't like to do this, but I'm just going to run downstairs and I'm going to take my drill press and just drill a tiny little hole in each of these holes. I guess the thing they don't like about it is when you take a punch like this and you punch it through, you're not removing any of the material. But I'm not really worried about that. And we've already got it glued together and everything, so that'll be fine. So I'm just going to drill little holes all the way down, and then we'll come back and we'll stitch her up. So we got our holes drilled, so we're going to do some sewing. You can use whatever needle you like, but I use these. I wish I could tell you what number they were, but they're just a little needle. The point is not extremely sharp at all. So I don't know the number size, but I mean, even if you had a sail needle, that would work too. So there you go. There's all kinds of threads too that you can use. You know, I got like waxed and colors and that. But I'm a big fan of the artificial sinew, so that's what I'm going to use. So just to get you started here, let's just peel some of this off. Now this doesn't look like very far, but you should have at least four times that amount of thread, and then when you got that much, a little more. We're going to put a needle on each end of the thread here, do kind of like a saddle stitch. So I'm just going to show you how to put the needle on the one side. So we'll just poke her through like that, and then bring it around a bit, and then roll the needle over, punch through that sinew again. Hope you can see that. Pull it down, and there's your needle. It's not going to come off of there. It's pretty simple. Nothing to it. Do the same thing on the other side, and then we'll get cracking. I'm not going to get caught up teaching you any fancy stitches or anything today, but I will do this. If these are holes, right? What we're going to do is we're going to start on the third hole, pulling the needle through. So now we've got the string, needle on both sides, right in the center. Pull it up. Then we're going to go back, through, and then back up. And then basically we started here. All that does is lock this in. And then we're just going to go like this. Right, you get the point. But then when we get to the end, we're going to turn around and we're going to come back two holes, and we're going to bring both tails through two different holes out the end, and then I'll show you when we get there. But if you want to learn the saddle stitch, there's a good video by Black Owl Outdoor, does a nice saddle stitch video. But like I said, for this, you don't have to get too carried away. Just go through, pull at the center, and then just stitch your way back, and then back two holes, forward two holes, and then you're starting from where you started, if that makes sense, and then you go. Then that the start is locked in, and the same thing when you get to the end. Get to the end, turn around and come back the same way. Two more holes and you're locked in again. And then I'll show you how I finish up the stitching. If you have a vise or something that you want to put it in to hold it upright, that would work for you, so you get both hands. I have this little stitching pony that I made years ago, but you don't even have to do that, to be honest. You can do it on your lap, but I'm going to use this, and I'm just going to get this started, and then loosen her up, get her in. Tighten her up. Okay, so I'm just going to get us started here. So I'm going to start, say, three holes in. Find my center. Alright, then I'm going to go back. I'm going to go pull this one through, pull this one through. Alright, pull them tight. There we go. Same thing. Hold it up. Is that? Okay, now we're in. Now we're going forward again. You're going to pull it tight every time you do it. Like I said, the saddle stitch, if you learn it, it will actually knot it each one, but it's not overly necessary on such a small thing, but it's good to learn, and I should be preaching to myself. But okay, now I'm just going to work my way up to the end and go back two holes, and then I'll show you there. Okay guys, we've made it to the end. We've come out like so on the end. So all we're going to do now is we're going to take our knife, leaving about a good healthy 1/8, 3/16 sticking out. Maybe you want to watch that. We'll just kind of melt that and push it right in there. Look at that. That will never come out of there. Alright. So that's your stitching. So now we're going to move on to burnishing. Now burnishing is basically creating a friction on the leather to make it smooth on the edges. So what I use is that's what this is, it's a burnishing tool. If you don't have any something like this, just find something that, you know, will take that angle and you can rub it on back and forth, but it's always a good idea to get a little bit of water and a little rag or a little dauber like this, and we'll just wet that. Wet it up real good. That seems to help the fibers all mesh together. And then all we're doing is rubbing that. Back and forth, rolling it over. And you can already see, can you see that little shine on there? So, I don't know why I really like doing this. It's a satisfying little part of the job. Yeah, it's got that buff shine on there. That will take the stain and everything. So it's fun. So you continue to do that, like, oops, on all the edges, even these little guys. You just go like that. You see that? It's like a smooth round edge. And again, not necessary. I should have said that too about the stitching too. Stitching, not necessary. You can just pound that full of rivets if you want, but I like a little bit of stitching. But Gransford doesn't care. See that? And we're trying to make that shiny smooth. So it just depends what you're in for, or what you really like, or what you have time for. So I'm going to go around, I'm going to burnish all the edges, and I'll be back. And we're just about got her done. So if you see that, all these edges are round and shiny smooth. This makes for a nice little added whatever. Okay, this is where we are. So now we need to get a snap on here, but we're just going to put the holes in for now because I want to stain it before I put any of the brass hardware on. Okay, so let's take our snips, and on here I want to have a little bit of finger room to grab to peel it off, so I'm not going to go too far. So I think we'll go, let's see, where's my pen? If that's the, I think we'll keep it a little bit lower. Put the snap right about there. So, punch a hole in there, on the center, close to center. Okay, punch, drill, whatever. Okay, now, to mark this here, you cannot do that without the axe in the sheath. So, at least to keep it tight. So, let's get the axe in the sheath. Like that. I'm just going to roll that over so it feels real tight. And make it tight too, because if anything, it's going to loosen. It won't tighten on its own. So, and we'll just mark a hole where it feels good. Okay. Take your punch. Punch the hole. Okay. So. Okay. Let's dye this baby up. Okay, guys. So I have learned, as much as I don't like to, is to wear gloves, because this leather dye changes the color of your skin for days, if not weeks, if you get in there. So get your gloves. I'm gonna use this is a water-based stain. I know the oil is better, but this is very low smell, and we're gonna go with a saddle tan this time. So I'm gonna open her up. Again, you can use a rag, or you can get these fun little cotton daubers. They're good for everything. So can't really go wrong with this stuff. Basically, you just kind of put her on until it's saturated. There's no, once it's taken all it can take, it just basically lays on the top. So it's pretty easy going. It's a very satisfying part of the project. Just get her in all over. Alright, so it's still wet to the touch, but it's not coming off too bad. But see that color, how the, if I get a little flex, you can see what the true color is going to be. It's going to be nice. Alright, so time to put these screws in here. I actually made a mistake, guys, so I had to redo my holes a little bit bigger. I know that, so this snap is going to be the full button, shiny side up. So the Chicago screw, one side is a screw head and one side is a flat head. So we're going to keep all the shiny heads on the one side. So we're going to push that in there like that. Just screw together. If you want to, you can always put some Loctite if you think it's going to come apart, but it's not. But if you think it does, it'll put, you can put some Loctite in there, and I'll just do, well, do these next two, and it'll be time to put on the snap. Okay, so we got the screws all in, so we're done, except for the snap here. So when you buy these snaps, you usually get these two little anvils, and then a little setter that you tap on. Now they come with instructions, so I won't get too carried away with it, but basically you've got these, so they will go like that. You need the bottom, which will be the flat post, like that. So this is what makes up the snap. So this will go in the hole. Like that. And then this just sits on there like that. We put it on the little mini anvil so that it doesn't dent up the bottom. Take our little setting tool, and all we're doing is mushrooming that point. We're just rolling that top edge down so that it holds together. So now I kind of turn it as I go. I don't know if that does anything or not, but there's your snap. And then basically, not basically, exactly the same thing with a different post in the, get my big paws out of the way. From the bottom, it goes up. Can't find it. There we go. That sticks up like that. And then this part goes on there, and we do the same thing with the other side of the anvil. You can see one side's round to hold the button, and the other side is flat with the point. So we're going to do the same exact same thing. Guys, so let's put her on there, snap her on, and there you have it. It's still damp, so I'm gonna let it dry overnight, but tomorrow morning I'm just going to get a hair dryer and warm the leather, melt some beeswax, and just work it in there and get a good polish. She'll be good. So there you have it. This is a heavy-duty sheath. It's gonna last more than a lifetime if you don't chop with it on. So there you go. Now, I did not make this axe, but I have a handle painted red, I have a little lanyard, and I have my own little sheath on there. So I didn't make it, but this axe is mine. It's the only one like it, and I like that. And that's what I do to all my tools. So twice as thick as this one, and I think it's better. You can get products like this tan coat finish, or all kinds of different finishes too if you don't want to do the beeswax. But I hope you like this little tutorial. Like I said, I hope I gave you different ways to do each step. Like, you don't have to have all the proper tools, and give it a try. Like, it's really not hard. Like I said, I'm not a leather worker, I'm just a dabbler in everything. So I think it looks good enough, and it's not that hard. It's very easy, but the thing is, you just have to try. So give her a go, guys. Easy peasy. So thanks for watching this video, and I'll catch you in the next one. See ya.